ان الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان محمدا عبده رسوله اعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا ايها الذين امنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن الا وانتم مسلمون يا ايها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحده وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والارحام ان الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا ايها الذين امنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم اعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما اما بعد فان اصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الامور محدثاتها وكل محدثه بدعه وكل بدعه ضلاله وكل ضلاله في النار وقال تعالى في كلامه المجيد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والعصر ان الانسان لفي خسر الا الذين امنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي Indeed, all praises for Allah and may peace and blessings be on the last messenger of Allah, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. My dear brothers, today in this khutbah, we will have a small glimpse, a small look at what Allah has prepared for His slaves, for His servants in Jannah. We know that this life is a test. It's an exam. Any exam has to have results. It has to have the day when the results will come out. And that day for this examination is the day of judgment, Yawmul Qiyamah. Allah Rabbil Alameen, who created us in this world, for Him to create us again is not difficult at all. And my dear brothers and sisters, my dear brothers, we see that Allah Rabbil Alameen has prepared the recompensation for His slaves. If a person does good, he will get good in return. And if he does bad, then he has to face the consequence of his actions. So Allah Rabbil Alameen has prepared Jannah and He has also prepared Jahannam. Jannah is a reality, and Allah has said in the Quran, "U'iddat lil muttaqeen," that Jannah is ready for those who have taqwa. Surah Al-Imran, Surah 3, verse 133. Those who have taqwa, Allah has made Jannah ready. It is ready. While we sit and talk over here, Jannah is ready in all its splendor and beauty. It is not that it is under construction. The offer was there, but now it's being prepared. It's already ready. So my dear brothers, we know that all the prophets of Allah, they promised this. And this is the reality and the truth. And why is this subject so very important? Because when we live in this world, and this world is full of trials, it's full of tests. Many a times a person has to choose, should I choose dunya or should I choose akhirah? Should I take the temporary benefit of this dunya or should I look at the permanent benefit of the akhirah? So at such times, if we remember that what is ready for us in Jannah, so the decision will become easy. When we have to decide dunya, akhirah, the decision will become easy when we have correct information given to mankind by all the prophets of Allah, including the last prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If a person was to look at this universe, it's not difficult to understand that the one who made this vast universe, for him to prepare Jannah is not difficult. If we look at the various kind of creatures which live in this world, the various kind of fishes, various kind of creatures that are living, when we look at our own body and the systems inside the body, it's not difficult to understand that the one who has made all of this, for him to prepare Jannah is not difficult at all. And what do we think? Will Allah Rabbul Alameen let the matters be mixed up as it is in this world? In this dunya, we see matters are all mixed up. There are people who do good, there are people who do bad. There are blessings which come on both, there are trials which come on both. It's all mixed up. But it's not going to remain mixed up. Allah is going to separate the worthy from the unworthy, and they are going to get what they deserve. So Allah Rabbul Alameen is going to give the fullest recompensation. And my dear brothers, whatever blessings we see in this world, whatever happiness we see in this world, this is just an introduction of what is happiness. If we were not to get even this much, we would not be able to even comprehend what is happiness. But there is real happiness only in Akhirah. There is real happiness, lasting happiness only in Akhirah. In this world, it's only an introduction. We get good taste when we eat food. We feel comfortable in certain surroundings. We like to see some things. This is just an introduction. For example, if we were not to get this introduction also, what would be our state? It would be like a small child. You take a very small child, you say that, come here. You keep a, you can say 10 KD note, huh? And keep a chocolate worth some fills. And tell the child that choose between these two. And do you know, a very small child, I have done this experiment myself, will choose the chocolate, which is worth a few fills, because he still doesn't know what, how much chocolate can come with that note. The day he gets an introduction that with this much, I can get so many chocolates, that day his choice will change. For us, when we have seen what is happiness in this world, it's an introduction, so that we choose the real happiness of Akhirah. The real happiness of Akhirah. So let's start. We have a very small khutbah, and in the Quran, Allah has given us glimpses of Jannah. And in this khutbah, I will give you glimpses from those glimpses, so that we can aim and choose better in our life. Let's start. As Allah has said in the Quran, "Aadattu li ibadiyya salihin, ma la aynun raat, I have prepared for my righteous servants that which the eyes have not seen, wala uzunun samiat, the ears have not heard of, wala khatar ala qalbi basharin, and the thought has also not come in the heart of man. Eyes have seen some beauty. Our eyes have seen beautiful scenes. We have seen beautiful scenes in this world. Maybe a person has not himself seen. Maybe he has seen images. Maybe he has seen wallpapers. He knows what beauty is. So Allah says, "Mala aynun raat," what your eyes have not yet seen. What you've seen is nothing compared to what is prepared. Subhanallah. And what your ears have not even heard of. And what you can imagine, it's much better than whatever you can imagine. See, like for example, let's say, take an example, there's a child in the womb of the mother. If we had a way to tell the child that, see, child, you know, when you come out in this world, you will find there's a nice big sky, there's a very big earth, there is water, there's sea, there are oceans, there are aeroplanes, there are mobiles, there are buildings. Now that child in the womb of the mother, if we were able to communicate, will he be able to understand this world? Not possible. So what we are thinking and imagining, Jannah, you know, it's nothing. We don't know what's Jannah. Allah's Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he told us that Ma la aynun raat, it is what eyes have not seen, wala uzunun samiat, huh? And ears have not heard of, wala khatara ala qalbi basharin, and the thought has also not come in the heart of man. So now I have divided this subject into four parts. Now, even if I don't finish all four parts today, I want you to know the four parts. That's why I'm mentioning the four parts. Why? When you read the Quran and when you read the descriptions about Jannah, maybe you can put in one of these four parts. This is my basic categorization. First part is, how is Jannah? How beautiful is Jannah? How wonderful is Jannah? You know, the Prophet ﷺ said, he said, it's a recorded hadith recorded in Sahih Bukhari, that the place of a whip, keeping a whip in this world, a whip, or the place of keeping a bow, or place of keeping a hand in Jannah, is better than everything in this world and all that is on it. Just a small place in Jannah, not even one square foot of Jannah is better than everything in this dunya and everything that is in it. That one square foot of Jannah is so beautiful that we cannot compare it to even the full world put together. It's much better. So you can imagine the place called Jannah. This is the first section, the place called Jannah. The second section is, if I imagine a person is staying in a very beautiful place, but his body is not healthy, he is sick, so he won't be able to enjoy. So the second section is our bodies in Jannah, the bodies of people of Jannah.
What are their bodies? How are their bodies? What is their clothing? What is the state of their heart? Huh? So see, the surroundings are also beautiful. And the person who's there in those surroundings, even he is in a very good state. Now imagine that there's a very beautiful place and a person is staying in it, but he's alone, he doesn't have company. So no, the third section is the company in Jannah. Whom are we going to meet in Jannah? Who are the people in Jannah? Whom are we going to interact with people in Jannah? This is the third section. And the fourth section is, if a person, imagine, he is in a beautiful place, body is also good, people are also nice, but nothing to do. The fourth section is activities in Jannah. Many people don't know the various type of activities in Jannah. So now this is just, these are four sections to know what Allah has prepared. And the more we know about Jannah, the more a person can feel it. He can be grateful for what Allah has given. This life is nothing. What is this life? You know what is this life? 50 years, 60 years, 70 years, there we have crores and crores and crores of years. And you know people give importance to this world. See, there's a very nice story. It's a similitude that at one place they had a king, they had a rule that whatever king we have, we will have him for 1 year, 1 year, let him do whatever he wants. After 1 year, we will go and put him in one barren, very deserted place, desolate place. So they had several kings coming for 1 year, enjoying for 1 year, and then they would go and put him in that desolate place. Finally, one king was appointed. He came. He said, I want to go and see that place. I want to go and see that place. So when he went to see that place, he found that all previous kings had died and very miserable state of affairs. He said, I want to make a palace here. In this desolate place, I want to make a palace. I'm the king for 1 year. So I'm telling you to make a palace for me here. I want to plant trees. I want to make a nice garden. I want to make this. So he spent that 1 year preparing that place. And after 1 year, when they went and put him over there, so he was happy. Now this is the state that people focus only on this dunya, 30 years, 40 years, building up, I want property, I want a good house. Yes, who's stopping you? But that's not your goal. We are going to leave that house and go in our grave without anything. But the real house where we are going to spend crores and crores of our life, crores and crores of years of our life, we're not doing anything to prepare that world, prepare that place to prepare something good for us. So let's start the first section. The first section is the place called Jannah. So we know that the places Allah has prepared gardens beneath which rivers flow. Now we can imagine several beautiful sceneries, isn't it? Gardens, rivers, but this is nothing compared to what Jannah is. And you know the place, the palace, let's have one example that what is Jannah made of? The Sahaba asked that what is Jannah made of? The Prophet ﷺ said, لَبِنَةٌ مِنْ ذَهَبٌ وَلَبِنَةٌ مِنْ فِدَّةٌ. One brick of gold and one brick of silver, alternate. Gold and silver bricks. Jannah is made of, the walls in Jannah, they're made of, the palace, the mansions in Jannah, what are the construction material? Is it made of these kind of bricks? So no, the brick is of gold and the brick is of silver. Subhanallah. And that's your place. Huh? Your place, if we deserve going there. See, there are no shortcuts to go there. Stop wishful thinking. There are some people who say, nahin pahunchi jayenge. This is fooling yourself. It's not fooling anyone other than ourselves. But that place where the bricks are of gold and silver, it's ready. It's ready. And subhanallah, imagine the beauty. And how big is it? How many square feet of Jannah is the person going to get? How many square feet? So Allah has said, Arduha samawatu wal ard. In Surah Al-Imran, that the width is that of the heavens and the earth. From the heavens and the earth, how big is it? How big? That is the width of Jannah. And Jannah is how big? Very big. Very big and vast. And how much time does a person get to stay? We know that there are places which are beautiful. Okay, so much time, now your time is over. Now you need to go out. You have an agreement of 11 months. No. We find that in Jannah, Allah said, خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا أَبَدًا. They will stay therein forever. And we find that in Jannah, a person will get whatever he wishes for, whatever he desires for. لَهُمْ مَا يَشَاؤُنَا فِيهَا وَلَدَيْنَا مَزِيدٌ. They will get what they desire there. What you wish there. We have hadiths like, for example, hadith recorded in Sunan Tirmidhi with a Hasan Sanat. One sahabi asked Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, will there be a horse in Jannah? Now he was interested in having a horse. Will there be any horse in Jannah? So Prophet said, yes, you will get a horse. You can get a horse which is of rubies, huh? And corals, and which will fly. Then a sahabi asked Rasulullah, can I get a camel in Jannah? Rasulullah said, you will get what your heart desires. Huh? So what you desire. Subhanallah. So that place which is made by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and do you know, some people raise this objection. They say, after some time in Jannah, we will get bored. They don't know what they're talking of. You know, the last person to go in Jannah, the hadith recorded in Sahih Bukhari, the last person who will enter Jannah, he will be told, Allah will say that you will get everything in this world, something which is equivalent to everything in this world and double in Jannah. And when Allah says that Allah will give you more, لَهُمَّا يَشَاؤُنَا فِيهَا, what you desire, وَلَدَيْنَا مَزِيدٍ, and much more from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we don't know that Allah Rabbul Alameen, how He's going to give. See, my dear brothers, we can see that our minds can come to an end. That okay, I want this. But when Allah says, you will get this to you, now this is for you. Now this thing is for you. So we see that there is no end to what Allah has prepared. And of course, there's one verse in the Quran, Surah 35, verse 35. Allah says that in Jannah, there will be no tiredness. And there will be no boredom. There's an explicit verse that there will be no boredom in Jannah. Nobody will get bored in Jannah. It's clearly specified. So the place called Jannah, we know that there are rivers. And I'm really running out of time. So I'll just quickly skim through. There are rivers. And the rivers, the four types of rivers of Jannah, we know famous, of pure water, of milk, of wine. And the wine which is mentioned in Jannah, there's no gall. And there's no harm. There's no intoxication due to that wine. And there's no harm due to that wine. It's enjoyable. It's an enjoyable drink. And also of honey. And there's one more river which many people don't know. And this is the river called Kauthar. And this is a river which flows from from the highest level of Jannah. It flows from there. And we know on the Day of Judgment, it is in the form of a pond. It's a hawz-e-kawthar. There it becomes a pond, but in Jannah it's a river. So that is also another river of Jannah. And the Prophet ﷺ said, its water is pure like snow. The color of that water is pure like snow. And he said that its banks are made of gold. These are authentic ahadith. And its pebbles are rubies and pearls. So we know that all of this beautiful place, the Prophet ﷺ said in a hadith, that the trunks of the trees of Jannah are made of gold. So this is the beautiful place called Jannah. I've just covered very little. We go further, our bodies. We are bodies in Jannah. So there won't be anybody old in Jannah. There won't be anybody who's sick in Jannah. Huh? There's nobody who's sick. There's nobody who's old. The average age of the people of Jannah, according to one hadith, we find it's 33 years. So average age is 33 years. And the height of the person in Jannah is sittuna ziraan fis sama. 60 cubits high towards the sky, meaning the bodies are tall, they're very, very tall. And that was the height of Adam. The height of Adam in Islam was much more than the average height today. So we find that the bodies of the people in Jannah are free from sicknesses, disease. In fact, the Prophet ﷺ said in a hadith recorded in Sahih Bukhari, he said that they won't go to urinate. Huh? So there are no sewers in Jannah. They won't be going for urination or for the motions. Huh? They won't be getting that. Then how do they digest the food? The Prophet ﷺ was asked. He said it is just in the form of a very nice burp, which gives a sweet smell, not a foul smell. And this will be, the food will get digested. Now, very important thing of the food of Jannah, we need to understand the body is also, that the food of Jannah is not to fill the stomach. Because when we read the hadith of Sahih Bukhari, where it's given that on the Day of Judgment, the believers will get the drink of Al-Kawthar from the hands of the Prophet ﷺ. So in that hadith it's mentioned that after that they will not feel hungry. So that food is not to fill the stomach, it's for enjoyment. See, if it's to fill the stomach, you can eat a little bit, then you can't eat anymore. But when it's for enjoyment, you can eat as much as you want, enjoy as much as you want. See, in the dunya, when you eat more, then you have problems in your stomach. But in the Akhirah and Jannah, a person can have all that he wants. And we find that the hearts of the people of Jannah, as Allah has said, وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي صُدُورِهِمْ مِنْ غِلِّنْ, we will remove from their hearts any kind of gillin, any kind of hurt, any kind of bad thing. Nothing bad will be left in their hearts. So their bodies are good, but even their hearts are pure. Huh? Their hearts won't be carrying hatred. They won't be carrying jealousy. They won't be carrying wrong things. And Allah will purify their hearts. Their hearts are pure, so they are light-hearted. They are happy, truly happy. They are grateful. So we find that in the dunya, we go through several difficulties. But in just one round in Jannah, as the Prophet ﷺ said, that a person would go through a lot of difficulties in this world, and he will be just taken for one round in Jannah and back, and then he will be asked that, did you go through any problem in this world? He said, no, I never had any problem in the world. And there would be a person who was very happy in this world, in great luxuries, and just one round in Jahannam, and it would be asked that, did you get any happiness in this world? He would say, I never got any happiness in this world. So we find that this is Jannah, the hearts of those people who go to Jannah. Also the clothing, we find the most luxurious, the best clothing. Allah Rabbul Alameen has prohibited gold for men. But in Jannah, there is gold jewelry. Allah has prohibited silk and satin for men in this world. But in Jannah, the garments will be of silk. The restrictions that were there, those restrictions, they are not there. And there will be full enjoyment, there will be luxury, there will be happiness. And this is the body. Now we come to the third section, and that is the company in Jannah. There won't be anybody who is unmarried in Jannah. Allah has said that Allah will marry them to the Hurul Een, and the males are married to the Hur, and the females will also have partners. They will have their spouses, and Allah Rabbul Alameen will provide for them spouses, purified spouses, as it's mentioned in the Quran. So suppose, for example, there's a husband and wife and both go to Jannah. So they will be purified over there. Over here in this world, they are worldly people. They have good things, they also have shortcomings. But in Jannah, there are no shortcomings. So some people say, she's my wife in this dunya, and she'll be again there in Akhirah, but she will be someone else. Imagine, I want to share this with you, that the Prophet ﷺ said about the hoors, that if a hoor of Jannah was to look towards the world, it would be, all the space between the skies and the earth would be full of beautiful smell. If a hoor was just to look towards the earth, it would be full of light and beautiful smell. And he said that a small portion of the scarf of the woman of Jannah is better than the dunya and everything in it. So now this is the Hurul Een. Imagine what will be the state of the worldly women who have the choice of لَهُمْ مَا يَشَاءُونَ فِيهَا. They will get what they desire. Huh? So you can imagine that if the hoor are so beautiful, then how beautiful are the worldly women going to be? And of course, the hearts are purified, so they are not having all the negative things that are part of human beings. Human beings are part of good and bad. So we find that spouses will be joined together, and they will be together. We find Allah has provided hoors, and I know there are some people who raise objections to this, that why should men get? See, it's very clear, this is the place for recompensation. And Allah is going to recompense in a way which is most the best way. The best recompensation Allah has prepared. And it's according to the nature. Women don't desire to have many men, many husbands. Allah has made their nature that way. And Allah has put a nature in men so much that one sheikh, once he tried one thing to his class. He said that, okay, I'm giving you 15 seconds. Just write down that what is the one thing you go to Jannah, what is the one thing that you want? And the result was, after 15 seconds, all the men had written, you know what they had written. But all the women, after 15 seconds, they were asking for more time. We give us some more time, let us think. So Allah knows what they want. Allah will give them what they want. They themselves don't know possibly, but Allah knows what they want. So Allah is going to recompense them in the way that is best. And this is in company, we find there's nobody alone. There are partners. There is hoor, whom Allah has prepared for men. And hoor, as Allah has said, that Atrab, they are of the same age, same type. We find that they are like eggs preserved, like pearls preserved. You know the preserved pearls, if you just touch it also, now, if your hands are very clean, still it will leave a kind of a print on it. So they are those hoors, they are so like those pearls preserved, so beautiful and so pure and so untouched, unseen. And they are prepared, Allah has prepared them as recompense. Similarly, we find that the angels will be receiving the believers. That Salamun Alaikum, peace be on you. Tibtum, very well, you did very well. Faneema Ajrul Amileen, how great is the recompense of those who do do the good deeds. Very good. This is the, look at the angels receiving them. Look at the company. The Prophet ﷺ said that you will be with those whom you love. Whom you love, you will be with those. So a person can get to meet the Prophet ﷺ. Imagine the Sahaba, the righteous, the Salihin. And we find that part of the company, many people don't know. They think that Jannah, beautiful place, and you are alone. But Allah has mentioned in several places in the Quran that they will be sitting on couches of mutaqabileen, one opposite one another, in front of one another. Now this is a place in Jannah. Jannah is very big, a place in Jannah. Well, this is also there, that there will be couches of, according to another verse of the Quran, there will be lined up couches. So the people of Jannah, they will sit opposite one another and they will sit and talk. And we find that people who knew each other in this world, they will be able to talk and they will share things. As someone said, that one day there was no Wi-Fi signal at home. So everyone came out from their rooms and they sat in front of each other and they sat and they just talked. And they said, such good people stay in my house. Huh? So we find that we are getting lost. We are not enjoying the beautiful things, and the people of Jannah sitting and talking in front of each other. And do you know, there are verses in the Quran that the people of Jannah, they will also talk to people of Jahannam. They will ask that, did you find Allah's promise to be true? So communication, we can understand, it's not so difficult. When we can sit here and call up America or any other place, it's not difficult to understand that people of Jannah and people of Jahannam will also talk. And there will be communication, and the communication, the meeting the prophets. But do you know the best thing is meeting the liqa with Allah, where we will see our Lord. And the best thing is the honor Allah will give. Do you know the honor which Allah will give to the believers? You know that the people of Jannah will be given an honor. What honor they'll be given? That there are some people who will go to Jahannam due to their sins, but they will have belief in their heart. Until hatta yakuna fiha humaman, until they become charcoal in Jahannam. Finally, thumma tudrikhumur rahma, they will find the mercy of Allah and they will be removed. But how Allah will remove? Allah will send the people of Jannah that go, whom you know from the people of Jahannam, who are going to be removed, you go and remove them. For example, you will find, this is a worldly example, it's not at all comparable, but for us to understand, we find that some organization organizes a program, they have a chief guest, they want to give a prize. So they tell the chief guest, we want you to give. So that chief guest is giving, that doesn't mean he's giving from his pocket. The organizers are telling him to give. Allah Rabbul Alameen will remove them. It's not that there's a competition between Allah and these people, and these people are dominating and Allah wants to punish, and these people who are righteous people, they want to remove. It's not that. It's Allah's will. Final will is Allah Rabbul Alameen. And Allah has willed that those people who are in Jahannam, they've got their punishment of what they are due, what they had to get. Now they are deserving of coming out. So people of Jannah will be given this honor, that whom do you know, go and remove them. They will be given this honor, subhanallah. And Allah will ask, gather the people of Jannah, and will say that, are you happy with what you've got? So they will say, Allah, we have everything that you have given. We are happy. How can we not be happy? So then Allah will say, now I'm going to give you one thing, which is the best. And he said that I am giving you my pleasure, rada of Allah Ta'ala. Allah is razi, Allah is pleased with them. And now I'm never going to be angry with you. And we find that among the biggest blessing of Jannah is wujuhun yawma'idhin nadira ila rabbiha nadira ila rabbiha nazira. As Allah said in Surah Qiyamah, that on that day, there will be people who will be very pleased and they will be looking at Allah. So Allah Rabbul Alameen's wajh, a person will see in a manner which is most befitting for him. Laysa kamithli shay, there is none like him. So a person will get to see, and after seeing Allah, there is no blessing which is comparable to this blessing, the blessing of seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the third section, we are just trying to finish. The fourth section of activities, there are so many activities in Jannah which you need to read and discover. My dear brothers and sisters, my dear brothers, what we see is this life is finally a test. Allah has told us from the truthful prophets, with so many who came with clear evidences which any man can see if he doesn't close his eyes. It's very clear that the exam is always small, the result is big. Our examinations are 3 hours, but our careers depend on it. The whole year depends on it. So this life is small, we are living now. Make good choices. Strive against our nafs. We need to strive against our soul. We need to deny the suggestions from shaitan. We need to overcome the desires of our soul. We need to choose wisely. We should not be foolish that we choose small things and we lose out the big life of akhirah. Akhirah, let's make wise decisions. Let's stay with istiqamat, steadfastness, and let's become one of those whom Allah will admit to His paradise. We do dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh Allah, forgive us our sins, our shortcomings, and admit us to your Jannah. We need to do dua for Jannah, my dear brothers. This is also very important. We should ask Allah for His Jannah. So we do dua to Allah. Oh Allah, forgive us our shortcomings, and make us of those whom you will admit in Jannah. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب واستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده رسوله أما بعد فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وقال تعالى في كلامه المجيد يا أيها الذين آمنوا ادخلوا في السلم كافة ولا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان إنه لكم عدو مبين وقال تعالى وسارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة أرضها السماوات والأرض أعدت للمتقين اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد ربنا آتينا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب واستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.